Well, I'm making a jump out of Nemoto today, so this was kind of a short stay, and I definitely could come back here, I think, and check out some more things. But, surprise, surprise, I saw the weather. There's another typhoon coming. And there's this rain headed for Hokkaido again for like weeks. It just seems like it's never gonna end. So this trip has been awesome, however, I am getting a little bit tired of the rain. I just had really, really bad luck in that regard. So I need to decide what I'm gonna do, like, in the short term, long term here. My original intention was to go up to the most northern city in Hokkaido, a place called Wakanai. But I'm starting to think maybe not, because of the rain. So I'm thinking about going back down and just heading back towards Tokyo. I'm gonna go to a point where I can make that decision today and tomorrow. I'm going back to Obihiro. It was a place that I saw some fireworks like I guess 2 weeks ago or something. So I'm gonna go back over there, and I've got a place to stay tonight, and then I plan on jumping somewhere tomorrow. And I don't know if that'll be north or if that'll be south. We'll make that decision at some point between now and then. And last night I had an awesome day yesterday, but I'm kind of starting to actually deeply miss Katie. So that's playing a bit into my desire to head back south too. But mostly, is that in the rain? Like, it's just been a disaster with rain. So anyway, I gotta catch a ride before it starts raining, because it's on its way. So wish me luck. Oh yeah, I never had time to give a proper tour of the place that I stayed here. It was an Airbnb guest house. Like, it was a little house that she had turned into a house with little rooms that were lockable. So I guess they rebuilt the interior or something to make it like this, because it wouldn't make a lot of sense if there was a family living there or something. But there's a kitchen and then an open area, and then 6 rooms or something. There were 2 floors, so there were 6 rooms that people could have, and they all had individual locks on them and stuff. It was super clean. The lady was super, super friendly and nice. She gave me a lot of really, really good advice. Wrote me a really nice letter when I left, by hand. This is a really, really nice lady. So I left her a letter, and now I'm splitting. But yeah, totally cool place. I would definitely recommend staying there if you're in the area. Windy. I don't think I mentioned, but Obihiro, where I'm headed, is nearly 4 hours away by car. So I may have, this might be a bit far, but I think there's gonna be a lot more traffic in the direction that I'm going, because there's more substantial cities along that route than there were when I came out here and was just way out in the woods. So I'm kind of hoping that this goes a little smoother than that day did, but if it doesn't, hell, I still made it, didn't I? It took 2 minutes. I caught a ride, and I made it about 40 kilometers. It was easy, I think, because it's kind of rush hour time, so a lot of people are leaving that area and going to other cities in the region. So this lady picked me up. Unbelievably nice lady, as usual. We cruised down the road, chit-chatted about stuff, and now I'm in another town, and I'm going to try to catch a ride to the next town, which is another 40 kilometers away. It's starting to rain a little bit, but I came into a 7-Eleven and I bought a umbrella. Because remember, I had the one that girl gave me, and I forgot it, so I have not have an umbrella again, so that will avoid all horrible, horrible disasters, hopefully. Alright, so I'm about halfway there now, and it's maybe 11 o'clock. I don't even think it's 11 o'clock now. So today is going really good. I put my sign out at the last place, and the first car that drove by stopped. And it was this dude in a van. And honestly, it's the first time that I've been sketched out. He was, on appearance, a pretty sketchy dude. I don't know. The van was pretty dirty. There was a lot of stuff inside of it. And he just kind of had a hard look on his face. And I was you know what I mean? And then I noticed he had a dog. And the dog was really, really relaxed and really friendly. And I was okay, you know what? If this guy was a jerk, that dog would be a jerk. You know what I mean? I don't know, maybe that's stupid. I also kind of wanted to prove to myself that people here, I see that guy and I'm that guy's sketchy, but I wanna see that he's not sketchy. I wanna find out what's not sketchy about this guy. Why is this? I mean, he's helping a stranger. You know what I mean? So I was screw it, I'm gonna ride with this guy. Even though I was kind of And but the dog, at first appearance, I was that dog is not okay. That dog is sick. There's something wrong with this dog. And so like after I got in the car and it smells of dog pretty strong and it's like not the cleanest vehicle, probably the dirtiest vehicle I've been in here, but blah, blah, blah. The guy was cool. Like he was totally fine. Really nice guy. He said a few things that were a little bit not normal. but nothing like scary. He said that he had lived in Chicago. It's starting to rain. I'm going to get my umbrella. He said that he had lived in Chicago for a while. And he was asking me, like, why is everybody in America fat? And I was just like, you know, the food is different, blah, blah, blah. And this is my first unveiling of the umbrella, by the way. Open, please. It's not opening. Button. There we go. There we go. I got the cheap one. Maybe that was a bad idea. Yeah. All right. Things are back in business. Sorry about that. And he was like, why is everybody fat? And I was like, I don't know, just because food and culture differences. I mean, I don't know how to answer that question. And he was just like, this is what he says to me. He goes, the only women who weren't fat are strippers. I was just like, all right, dude. I don't know. So like he made more off-color remarks than anybody I've been in a car with. But at the same time, like you could just tell like he's not a dangerous person. He was an okay dude. But it was an interesting ride, and we cruised over this mountain range, and it's gotten pretty foggy, and just cruising through the fog. And then I went into this place called Supercenter Trial. It looks more like a Walmart than anything I've ever seen. Walmart has a strange presence in Japan. They own a group of stores called Seiyu, and they look kind of like a Walmart, but not exactly the same. There's just something not right. But this Supercenter Trial place has got the Walmart vibe nailed down just as much as I've ever seen in Japan before. That was kind of interesting to walk in and see, and I noticed a lot of the prices were super low, kind of like Walmart too. So I think Walmart's got to up its game if it wants to enter the market, otherwise Supercenter Trial might take it over. I think I'm about halfway to my destination. It's not even noon. I'm doing all right. I think I'll make it. And the rain, this is the first time I've been standing. This is the first time I opened my umbrella today. It's the first time I've had to. So today is going all right compared to a couple days ago where I had a really hard time getting around. Like just had to go a million places I didn't intend to go. So this is going all right. Anyway, here we go. Find another ride. Well, that rain that started got pretty substantial. So I ran across the street and now I'm in a 7-Eleven. Not sure what I'm gonna do now. It's raining pretty damn hard. So I'm gonna wait and hope it calms down a little bit and then hopefully try to find a way to get a ride or if at least find someplace covered. That's not very much fun. It just rained for about 10 minutes or something. So I'm back out here about to start looking for a ride. I think I may have gotten distracted and not explained the situation with that guy's dog that was that I rode with a few minutes ago. The dog was unhealthy as shit looking. And although it looked kind, I was a little like, whoa, what's wrong with this dog? You know what I mean? But it turns out that the dog is just really old. He said the dog was 16 years old. And I mean, you know, in dog years, that's like, you know, 140 or something. So, I mean, it was just, you know, the dog was checking out. And again, attitude-wise and everything, the dog didn't seem like it was in a bad situation. And when the guy told me how old it was, the guy sounded kind of sad. So, I mean, there's still definitely some humanity there. But yeah, that was a weird ride. Like, let's just put it that way. It was one of the stranger ones. But still was safe. Still got to where I wanted to go. It was all right. Grabbed a ride about 5 minutes down the road. And this lady pulled over and was like, yo, you're not going to get a ride. That happens sometimes, yeah. She was like, you're not going to get a ride. I got to go to work right now. But I'm going where you want to go, which is 2 hours away, by the way. She's like, I'm going there tonight. I can drive you there, but we can't leave until 8 p.m. I was like, so can you just take me as far like down this road as you can? And she was like, but there's a highway, there's a bypass, and she's got this figured out. Like, bypasses are a hitchhiker's nightmare because if you end up in a city, you got to get to the damn bypass to get going long distances. It's a really big hassle. So you got to figure out like where to go to get onto that bypass road and all that. So she was just like explaining like, you're gonna have a really hard time finding a ride and blah blah blah. I don't think it'll be that big of a deal. And she was like, look, if you can't get a ride, come back here. I get off at 8 o'clock, we can go together. So I've at least got a backup plan. but I'm gonna see if I can figure out a way to get there a little earlier than that. That's my goal. Punching back another Garana because they're amazing. And remember, I was like, at first I was like, this is from Japan. And then later I was like, I think this thing is from like the Amazon or something. And I was like, I don't know. So I talked to Katie like a couple nights ago. I was like, yeah, do you know what Garana is? And she was like, yeah, it's that stuff from South America. I was like, totally knows what it is. So I'm sure everybody's just gonna be like, does he not know this? Whoops. Hey, I know I'm messing around. These bypasses suck. I've been walking for, I don't know, an hour or two now. And it's just like location, location, location. That's what's most important thing. I'm in the wrong location with trying to go the direction nobody's going. Like everybody is just tootling around town where I'm at. Nobody's going long distances. And I just had a lady stop and she was going where I'm going, Obihiro. And like I said before, I've been there. And she was like, where are you trying to go? And I was like, I'm just Obihiro. And it's a big area. And she was like, okay, well, I'm going to the city. And she was like, where would I be able to drop you off? I was like, any place is okay. Like maybe by the train station or something. And she was like, they don't have a train station. And I was like, what? They have, like, I don't want to argue with the lady. Like she has an Obihiro license plates on her car. And I was like, but yeah, I was like, there's a train station there. And she was like, no, there's no train station. And I was like, okay. What's happening? I was like, I'm in the Twilight Zone or something. And I was like, okay, like I've been inside of it. So I was just like, okay, well, like any place is okay. And she was like, well, I guess we don't know where to go and probably not. So I mean, maybe she was just sussing me out and she didn't like me after she talked to me for a minute or something. I thought I was cheerful and smiley, but maybe not, I don't know. So yeah, this lady was like, there's no train station there. And I'm like, okay. Really strange situation. I'm just like, what is happening right now? So needless to say, I'm still walking. And part of my problem is that it's hard to tell where cars can go on and off of the highway. So I could like take a random shot and walk 2 kilometers in a direction that I think a highway entrance is, but maybe there's not a highway entrance there. So it's like, then I would end up walking 2 kilometers back. So I don't know. And it's raining a little bit. It's just sprinkling. The rain isn't so bad. It's mostly just annoying to hold an umbrella. I'm not soaked or anything. But yeah, that lady was, I'm really confused. I'm just like, what is going on right now? But you know, whatever, what are you gonna do? Eventually somebody will pick me up. It'd be nice if it was sooner than later. So I asked a dude at 7-Eleven, I was like, yo, like, do most of the cars, if they're going to the place I'm going, like, do most of them hit the highway from here, or do they take this normal road? And he was like, probably the highway. And I was like, all right, so I'm walking that way now. We're gonna take that gamble. There's a lot less cars going this way, but again, like, a majority of the cars that I saw earlier weren't leaving town. So maybe most of these cars are going towards the highway, and that means that, you know, there's actually a high, even though there's less cars, there's a higher chance of catching somebody going the direction I want to go. This is all still a learning experience. I've been doing it for like 3 weeks or something, and I'm still like, what should I write on my sign? Where should I go? And then earlier, honestly, if I had just looked at my map when I got dropped off, I probably would have been all right, but I didn't give it a strong enough look to understand that there was a bypass. I just looked, I was like, okay, there's a route, you know, that goes through. I'll use that, but I didn't realize how big this town was and that it would be a bypassable city. So, oh well, live and learn. All right, so I decided it's time for a break. My back is tired and it's just, I need to sit down. I'm hungry, so I decided to get a snack. Actually, lunch. This is lunch. And there's a convenience store called, Seki Mart or something? Seiko Mart? I don't remember right now. So there's a convenience store up here, and this is a Hokkaido convenience store. And I've heard that they have good bentos and good lunches and stuff. And I've noticed that when I go into them, you don't get reheated food. It's like, it's in a hot, like whatever opposite of a refrigerator is called. It's like, one of those big open refrigerators, only hot. So like a hot refrigerator or something. And that's where you get your food from. So I got something called a butadon, which is something that I've had quite a bit, and it looks a lot like a it looks a lot like gyudon actually, but with pig meat. So it's just, you know, pig meat with soy sauce and mirin and sugar and stuff all mixed together to make a sauce. So they cook it all, cook the meat in that sauce, and they put it all on top of rice. Oh, they put onions in it as well. In this case, they have also added a an onsen tamago, which is a half-boiled egg, and you will break that and then mix it in with the rice and stuff, and it makes the rice thicken up, and it's really good. And they also included a packet of shichimi, which is something that's common on gyudon, like at Yoshinoya and stuff, there's always shichimi there. And I put the shichimi on top. And now I'm gonna give it a try. So let's see what we got here. I'll show you the egg. I haven't actually broken the egg yet. So you can see this is with the shichimi on it and everything. And there's the wrong end of those sticks. And then I will break this open. You can see it's like half cooked. And they're called onsen tamago because sometimes in hot springs, if you put one of these eggs into the water at the hot spring, which is called an onsen, it'll cook it to about this consistency. I guess that's why they come up with that name. So anyway, let me break this up a little bit and get it in there. This looks so good to me right now. I'm so hungry. That's pretty damn good. Mmm. Yeah, like, so the guy that I hung out with yesterday, I went to the onsen and stuff with, he was like, you gotta try the food there. And I was like, alright, let me try the food there. And they've got like this logo, it's like with a cow, it says Hot Chef. And I haven't been trusting him, but now, he's on my good page, man. That cow can kick out something good. Maybe that's why they don't use beef for this. Alright, so the camera is precariously, dangerously balanced on my knee right now, and I'm trying to open this packet of this lemon cake, because, like, straight up, sometimes the girl's gotta treat herself, you know what I mean? So let's see what we got. Looks all right. So it's like just frosted on the top, cakey on the bottom. Looks kind of like something you would, like, just get at a Wawa or something, you know, like truck stop or something like that. They have these little sweet things. The lemon flavor is like really overwhelming. I swear I've eaten one of these. Did I talk about one of these already? It's possible. It's really familiar now. The cake is, this one's a little bit dry, but the flavor is good. All right. All right, so as soon as I got to the area where the highway was, just, of course, like, I'm in the right place with the right sign, and then boom, I'm moving. So I went into this parking area, and I went into a bathroom and used the bathroom. When I came out, there was this lady waiting for me. I guess she'd seen me on the highway and seen where I walked and basically followed me. Not on the highway, but on the big road leading up to the highway. And she followed me and waited, and she was like, hey, I'm going to Sapporo, which, honestly, that would have been awesome. But I had already booked an Airbnb here, and the reason I'm booking ahead is because of the weather. I don't want to get stuck out in the rain, and I don't want to get stuck with a super expensive place to stay. So, like, when you're hitchhiking, like, booking a hotel is sort of a bad idea, because, like, what if you don't make it? Or what if you have the opportunity to go further? Like, you're stuck. So I'm kind of stuck in that situation. But, again, like, it beats being out, like, out in a park in a typhoon, you know? Like, it's a gamble, and I'm not willing to risk it too much. Anyway, so I've got to my Airbnb, and it is in a, they call a mansion in Japan. And a mansion is basically an apartment with thick walls. It's the best way I can explain it. They're very, very common, and often, like, an apartment, I think my image of an apartment is, like, thinner walls and, like, usually a smaller type of building, but a mansion will be often a bigger area. This is not that case. This is a smaller apartment, a smaller sized mansion. But, like, families will often live in mansions and stuff because they're a little quieter, and I guess usually they're built of concrete and stuff as opposed to just, like, wood and stuff. I don't know if that's really technically correct or not, but, like, that's my image of a mansion. And they use the word mansion despite mansion not meaning mansion. In English, it's a totally different thing. So I've come into the mansion and I thought I would show you guys around. I'll be staying here alone, which is nice. And this was 3,500 yen. So like, you know, $35 or a little less than that, depending on where the exchange rate happens to be. And this is what you get. So, so this is, you come in here and it was cool. He just had a padlock on the door, which is awesome because I don't have to worry about meeting anybody. Like you don't have to arrange that time, you know, like I don't mind meeting people. It's just like, sometimes he's busy or I'm not here. And because I come in at random times, I'm not like on a scheduled train. It makes it a little bit tricky sometimes if you have to meet a person. Anyway, so you come in this door and of course you take off your shoes at the Genkan and then you go into the mansion. And I have not looked in here. What is this? Ah. Just a toilet. It's a washlet. That's lovely. I love washlets. Once you have one, like, you're like, what are people doing without this? Why do people not have an automatic butt washer? And, okay, so then, again, Genkan is back here. Forward. And you got a washing machine. And this is probably for the doorbell. And he's got a really nice, clean shower right here. And as you can see, that's all like in the entry hall, like a shower and a toilet and all of the, and the washing machine and stuff. And then from the shower room, come in and he's got a nice little living room here. Looks all right. Very clean. And, you know, kitchen, basic Japanese kitchen. Nice little refrigerator there. He's got it left opened and it's not plugged in. He says if you want to use it, plug it in. So he's just saving electricity, I suppose. And you know, all the necessities that you need for a Japanese kitchen. It looks like every other Japanese kitchen I've ever seen. And oh, whoa, hey, I've got the same water. We have the same water boiler at home. Nice. And a selection of some books and stuff. Look at that. Ooh, there are PlayStation games. Sweet, there's a PS2 over there. And I was like, oh man, I want to play some games, but I didn't see any discs. But now, maybe I'll play some, or maybe I'll see if I can find a cheap game that I want to play, like something, I could play like a racing game or something. I don't know, anyway. And then, so this is the area where I came in, and there's this wall, and it just separates the bedroom. So that's what we get, and that's where I will be sleeping. And, you know, I wouldn't want to live in this apartment with two people. It's reminiscent of the apartment that Katie and I had when we lived in Musashi Odawa, and you just don't have any way to, like, be in separate rooms. It sort of drives you insane. But, to live here alone would be totally fine. Like, I could be very comfortable here. I like a lot. I used to think lofts were cool. Like, we had a loft in an apartment, but I hate them now. Because it's just like, you're sleeping up in this loft, and you're like, man, I gotta pee. And you're like, I gotta navigate a ladder. And I'm like, you know, ugh, it's like all dangerous. So I like this layout quite a bit more. And it feels a little, it's like a wider feeling place too. And I don't know if we have any interesting views outside. Looks like it's just a little rainy city right now. And there's a balcony. Let's see what's going on the balcony. See if it's big. Whoa, there's another pane of glass. That's nice actually for cold weather. That's not common in Tokyo area. Hey, yeah, look at that, that's pretty big too. You could chill out here if you wanted to. That's much more spacious than the balcony we have in Tokyo. Hey, that's pretty nice. Yeah, so the lady that picked me up was going, like I said, she was going all the way to Sapporo. She was like super nice. She's visiting her mom in Kushiro, which is where I met her. And this is the day of the dogs. There was a little dog in there and it was like ancient. It was like 16 years old or something. And it was like a little miniature pincher. And it was like completely blind, I think, and it was really cute, but you're just like, whoa, that dog is like just holding on by a thread. But it was pretty calm and everything, but every once in a while it would just start coughing and stuff, and you're just like, I was gonna be awkward if this dog dies while I'm in the car with this lady. Like, I don't know, like, the proper way to console somebody for a dead dog in Japanese and stuff. I was getting a little concerned. But anyway, okay, so I'm here, and, of note, she told me, I had mentioned to her, I was like, I'm trying to decide if I want to go to Wakkanai, which is the northern city, or if I want to go back to Tokyo now. Like I explained earlier this morning, I'm feeling a little bit run down, honestly. And, kind of want to go home, like kind of got that feeling. However, she was like, oh, Wakanai is amazing. She's like, it doesn't feel like Japan at all. She said, it feels like Europe. And now I'm like, so I checked the map and it's like 6 hours from here. And I was like, how many cars go up there? And she was like, it's pretty sparse. Like, there's not a lot of cars driving up there. She's like, truckers go up there. And I was like, truckers never pick me up. So I don't know, man. I gotta make this decision tonight. So I'm gonna decide, and then I'm either going north or I'm going south. What should I do? What would you do? This is apparently a real telephone box from London. Which, of course, in London they probably don't have public telephones anymore, but in Japan, we still got public telephones, y'all. There it is, and it still works. In my search for dinner, I wandered around and I kind of ended up not in the red light district, but like the party district, and like, you know, people are dressed up, it's Friday night, people are out doing things, you know what I mean? Drinking with their friends and things. I ended up going into a little street that had a whole bunch of different bars on it and stuff, and one of them was a kushikatsu place, and that is something that Katie and I had when we were in Osaka, and it is like things on a stick. Usually it could be meat or vegetables or other odd things, and then they deep fry them. And they give you this like vat of sauce. If you've seen our Osaka videos, recent Osaka video, you'll probably know what I'm talking about. But they give you this vat of sauce. And then all these instructions, because the sauce is like a public like utility. And you're not allowed, the basic rule is you're not allowed to double dip. And so they give you all this thing, like, and they give you like some lettuce, and like you can dip the lettuce in the sauce, and then you can move the sauce onto the kushikatsu thingies, like your stick stuff. And it's not complicated, but it turns into this thing where everybody's used to being able to double dip, and everybody's used to being able to use chopsticks, and everybody's used to eating in a certain way. And this place throws all those like normalities out the window, and then has this set of rules. And all of the kushikatsu places I've been to have had this system. And it seems like it's more of just an annoyance for the employees, because the lady next to me just kept screwing up. Like, she just kept doing things wrong. She was kind of drunk. She was using her chopsticks into the sauce, and then she was putting, like, she almost double dipped it. And the lady's just, like, watching like a hawk. Like, yeah, like, don't do that, don't do that, don't do that. And it just seems like, why doesn't everybody just get their own sauce? It doesn't make sense why they've gone to all this trouble. I think maybe it's because it's like kind of like, oh, there's these rules and it's kind of interesting thing, and maybe it makes more people go, and I don't know, but they all have it, and it's bizarre. And as a foreigner, I go in there and they're like, do you speak Japanese? And I'm like, yeah. And they're like, do they explain everything to me in Japanese? And then they kind of like watch me out of the corner of their eye for the first 10 minutes I'm eating to make sure that I'm not, you know, screwing up. But anyway, beside all that, this was the best kushikatsu I've ever had. They had a vegetable platter, basically, like a set that you could order, and it had like tomatoes and potatoes and asparagus and stuff. So they take all of that and they put it into like a deep fryer, basically. And it's not heavily deep fried like a chicken. It's a kind of like a lightly deep fried, not like tempura, but sort of kind of somewhere in between the two. And it was just shockingly good. It was amazing. They deep fry onion, like a straight up an onion. And it's like eating onion rings. It's really like a really good onion ring. And of note, another thing that I had that was interesting is an Oreo cookie he deep fries and then puts like some whipped cream on top of it. And oh my God, it's good. You gotta go deep fry you an Oreo cookie. Like, it was unbelievably good. It seems like something you get at like a fair in like the Midwest in the United States or something. I'm sure that's a thing, like deep fried Oreos and stuff. But it's, oh my God. It's like knee knocking delicious. And then I heard some people talking about something that happens in this town that only happens in this town in the world. And I think I'm gonna stay an extra night here so I can check this out, and we'll save that for everybody for tomorrow. But yeah, this thing, I'd heard about it before and I forgot it was here, and then I just heard some people in the restaurant talking about it, and I was like, oh, we're gonna do that. Oh, also, if you're European and you have any like questions about what Japan, this is Japan's vision of Europe right here. There's the Moulin Rouge, y'all. I love the windmill. All right, so I've already eaten, so this isn't gonna happen right now, but I just walked down another street, and it's really cool. It's got yatai, which are like food stall kind of things, And they vary in what they look like. And these are kind of like, I ate one of these in Hachinohe at the beginning of my trip. And Katie and I have eaten them at different places as well. Fukuoka is famous for them. But anyway, there's a whole bunch of them down the street. And I was looking at the menus, and they have whale sashimi. And another place had raw lamb. Like, that's not normal. Is that healthy? Can you eat raw lamb? Is that gonna kill me? So it's pretty interesting, but it would be pretty expensive to go alone, because you'd end up having to go to a few different ones just to get like the things you want. Sometimes when you go to these little yatai areas, if you can order like, and they'll go down to their neighbors and get it for you, and then you just pay them, and like that works. But these places had signs up that specifically said they wouldn't, which is maybe they just got sick of people doing that, or I don't know, whatever. So yeah, but like whale, you can eat whale sashimi down there. I've never seen that on a menu. I'm sure you can get it in Tokyo, but yeah, maybe I'll save that for a Katie thing or something, because I think that'd be fun to eat with her. I feel like a dog with my head out the window. Hey everybody, I hope you enjoyed that hitchhiking video. It wasn't the most eventful video, but the next video has got something that's amazing in it. I'm really excited to share with everybody, so I hope you're looking forward to that one. And like, I mean, I think about like, I could cut this stuff out and like, but then it's like you lose continuity of the whole series and everything, so I thought it was kind of important to show that that's what it was like that day, to try to go from Nemuro to Obihiro, I think is where it was. And, you know, I don't know if this is part of the story, so I hope
it's
you enjoy.
It's one of those things where, like, every day of traveling is not spectacular.
Yeah, you know,
there's days that are just like, that was a day.
You don't know what happened this day. But
it didn't.
It rained.
Yeah, well, that's part of it.
And like, I got a ride with two dogs.
What?
Yeah, two dogs.
Are you recapping the video that they just watched for me?
Both of them were like, I doubt both of those dogs are still alive. They were old. Super
this
old.
This is the worst video you've ever recapped for me.
But the next video is amazing. It's got
all the dogs live?
No, it's got these amazing, it's got amazing animals. It's an amazing animal video.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. Oh, anyway, so yeah, we of course have, Patreon for financing our videos, and we have
Facebook and Twitter.
And there's a Reddit page, and yeah, we have a website too. If you want to see pictures and stuff from the videos, we have a website. It's just katieanderic.com.
I definitely like or subscribe if you're digging what you're watching. And keep in mind that this video that you've just watched is not the most stellar. So, you know, feel it out for yourself.
So, this is the first time we've done an end card in a long time where we could both speak, because the last one that we shot, I wasn't speaking. So, you don't know about this, but I made this graphic that shows people that next to the subscribe button is a bell that they can click to get notifications when we upload new videos. So if you don't want to miss anything.
What's the notification?
It's like,
to the top of your...
It'll go on here. Like, you can set it up to come to your box.
So it just goes straight to your notification bar?
Yeah, or you can set it up, I think, so it'll send you an email.
Okay.
As well. So I get emails from certain YouTubers that I've like clicked that bell on. But I don't have it on here.
What's the subscribe button mean now?
The subscribe button means like, if when you go to YouTube, you can see your list of subscriptions, which is how I usually browse stuff. But
so it's not adding people to the list of to the number of subscribers.
The bell has nothing to do with anything for us. It just means that people that don't want to miss a video, that they get something.
Okay.
So now you understand that, and everybody else understand that. And
yeah,
I would have at some point there overlaid this cool graphic I made that like zooms in and circles it and stuff.
Good.
Yeah, it's kind of ghetto looking. Anyway, I already made it. It's been on a couple other videos. I always forget to say this, though. We got a couple of questions that we thought we'd answer. Both of them are from YouTube, and the first one is from Sarah, and she says, she wants to know where we got those amazing curtains. And she's talking about these amazing curtains with these birds and on the branches and stuff.
This is from IKEA, and they actually come extremely long, and you're supposed to ask them to tailor them for you, like, while you shop, but the tailoring section was closed, so I've just brought them home and folded them over and sewed it up to the top. So it does give us two layers during the winter, which is great. It means that not as much cold is going to come in, but yeah, that's how you fix things when you have to fix things.
It's a little clumsy to move them and stuff.
Yeah.
And then we actually have another blanket.
The half fold is perfect for that window.
It fits.
It is the perfect size. I was really worried it's going to be really short or it's going to be really long, and it was just perfect.
And then we have another blanket there as well to keep more cold out, because the windows...
That's not there to keep cold out.
It's for light.
It's there so that we get no reflections on the television.
The light, though, man. The cold here, because the windows suck in Japan.
The windows suck, the walls suck.
They're, like,
suck.
Not double paned or anything. Yeah. So, like, when you sit next to a window, you can feel the cold air just coming through.
Yeah,
and
see,
it's terrible.
We have a window right by our heads, and I have to pat down
the curtain. In bed.
Yeah, so because you can just feel a stream. Like, if you just opened up a bit and, like, blew it at your face, it would, like, maybe cold burn you.
And then we also have these curtains hanging up in here. These are our cat curtains. Did those come from IKEA as well, or did we get those from Nitori?
They came from Shimamura, which
is
not a second-hand shop, but it is, like, all this stuff couldn't get sold in other shops, so therefore we're selling it in this shop.
It's like Big Lots.
Yeah, it's like Big Lots.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, good.
It's called Shimamura?
Shimamura.
Okay.
And they have clothes and stuff like that. And I went through there. I found these curtains, bought these curtains, like, no choice. And then I went back several times because we had other windows looking for cool curtains. Never could find any more cool curtains. It was all just, like, grandma curtains.
Those are, like, wonky grandma curtains. That's you.
I'm a wonky grandma?
A bit. And the next question is from Mizasu, and Mizasu asks, if you could redo any trip you've been on, which trip would you redo? I find that to be an interesting question. It's hard to answer, because I don't have regrets about stuff, really, like, at all, ever. Like, I refuse to do that to myself, so, like, I don't wouldn't want to redo a trip because I, like, did it wrong or something, because I don't feel like, you know, that's what happened in that moment or whatever. I don't think we've ever had a trip where we just didn't give it our all. You
the know? Only thing that comes to mind is the Philippines and not getting sick. But
that's not...
But I don't... want that. I want to know what that was and what that was for me, and I wouldn't want to erase that from my history, even though, like, that was not a cool thing.
No, it's very...
It was not
You have
cool.
a tropical infectious disease.
Yeah. So I might want to do that so that we'd get more time there, but then I wouldn't have this interesting experience that...
Can you think of anything in Japan you would do differently? Like, as far as, like, going on trips
I would
stuff?
Not have worn my rain boots during the snow festival in Hokkaido. I really thought that was, like,
that
the smartest
smart.
Idea. It's going to be real smart, but they transfer cold like nobody's business.
Yeah, like, ooh, the rubber through the sole went right through your foot. I would like to do... I don't think I'd like to redo any trips, but there's places I want to go again. Like, I want to go... I don't know if we'll ever have the chance, but when we went to Oman...
Oh, yeah.
Oman is so beautiful and so incredible, and we had an amazing time there, but we didn't... We should have stayed longer.
Mm-hmm.
But we just... Due to the circumstances, we couldn't. But, like, to have gone all the way down towards the border with Yemen and stuff would have been awesome. But the short time we were there for maybe a week or something. It was amazing. So I always think about that.
I say that this is a testament to my planning. I think it is. Like, we don't even want to redo anything, because I plan good.
But there's lots of places I'd like to go to. Hong Kong, we're going there.
We're going there in...
A couple weeks.
Five weeks.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
And then, a media shout-out. You haven't been around for a media shout-out yet.
Yeah.
I thought that... This is kind of obvious, I think, for a lot of people because of how much hype it's getting, but the media that I've been obsessed with lately is the new Zelda game on the Switch. It's also on the Wii U as well. It's so good. It's a masterpiece. I could just go... I've talked to her about this, like, endlessly. Like, how much I just, like, get lost, like, picking apples. What are you getting the computer involved? What are you doing? You bored?
Yeah, I'm bored.
What do you think of Zelda?
Oh, what do I? Oh, are we just doing one media shout out? Because
yeah.
I was getting my media.
Oh,
set
no,
up,
we'll save it for next
we'll
time.
We'll save my media yeah. for when I actually understand it.
Yeah.
Anywho, Zelda, I think, is pretty friggin' awesome. It's not even about,
it, so.
Like, just picking up the apples and how, like, picking everything apples. Is interactive. It is just about how beautiful it is in every aspect. Like, every puzzle, every fight. Every single, like, huge dungeon, I don't know if you consider, is the elephant considered a dungeon?
Kind of. Don't give any spoilers or
I'm
anything.
I'm not giving any spoilers.
I
said, is the elephant
kind
a dungeon?
Of. Yeah. Kind of, it's sort of. It's a.
If that spoiled anyone's Zelda experience, you know what? Zelda, I mean.
But it's just, you can climb to the top of a mountain and look across the huge valley at another mountain, and then you can go climb that mountain. It just doesn't make sense. It's huge.
Mm.
I can't believe people made this thing. It's that amazing.
I'm normally not that interested in playing Zelda games. I'm more than happy to watch. Like, I watch him play a lot of games because his gaming skills are just stellar. And he gets things better than I do. So I enjoy just watching him. It's like watching a television show. Like, it's just been done right. me doing it is frustrating and difficult. Maybe I just don't see that part of his experience.
I'm looking forward to watching her play the Zelda game.
Oh no.
Will you try?
Yes, I definitely...
You like video
that,
games.
That,
don't play this
thing.
Like you don't like
that's
video games.
That's what I'm trying to say. Okay, shush! Talk too much now. Jeez. I am compelled to play this game. I want to have that experience for myself. And I think the same thing happened with Mario Galaxy. Like, I watched him playing it and I was just like, that's so cool. And one day I was actually like, I'm going to pick up that remote. And I did. And I...
You beat it. You just didn't 100% it because that stupid level with the,
okay,
that one
yes,
purple
I did
coin
beat
level
it,
at the
but
end.
I did not finish that one level 100%.
Nobody did. Well, like
somebody
psychopaths
did. Yeah. But yeah, there's been a few days where you haven't been here and I was like, okay, I'm going to get that mouse. That remote control, but I don't really know how the Switch works yet, so I need a tutorial on that before I jump in and break a whole bunch of stuff.
To be honest with you, if you're not here, it's probably in my bag with me. That's the
and
other problem
I
with
hadn't
this thing.
Actually, you can see how like I have already stopped myself. I didn't even realize the Switch wasn't in the building. so I definitely want to try that just because it just looks like an incredible experience.
It is. So if you guys have the means, highly recommend it.
Mm.
It's a masterpiece.
Yes.
Things to come? More hitchhiking videos?
Hong Kong.
More Brunei videos? No, Brunei? More videos? No,
oh.
we're going into Malaysia on Borneo next in that series. I haven't edited it yet, but...
And today is our anniversary.
Oh yeah,
so
today,
our
we're
special day.
As we're shooting this today, it's
yeah.
April Fool's Day, which is
it's
our anniversary.
It's April Fool's Day, and it's our day. And we might make a video in relation to this. I have an idea, but we'll have to see if the place is open, so...
If we do make a video about it, they probably saw it before they saw this end card. Just because of...
If you already saw it, hooray!
Thanks, everyone.